This episode is brought to you by Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor stars as Count Alexander Rostov in A Gentleman in Moscow, the new limited series based on the best-selling novel. Stream it with the Paramount Plus with Showtime plan. Visit ParamountPlus.com to try it free.
Hey y'all, come on in. We about to get started. I'm gonna get some music started that way I can share the live. So if you just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits, okay? Y'all already know what the vibes is. Make sure y'all share the live, okay? If you're watching on Instagram, share the live. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the like button. I'm almost finished with the song. Share the live, share the live. I'm so used to being on Facebook and being able to share the live, but y'all know my arms be getting tired. So I did share the live a little bit on Instagram. I'm going to share it a little bit more. So let's get
started. Up in the struggle, appreciate the hood because it taught me how to hustle. Went through some hard times when I was down in my knuckles. I appreciate the ones who stuck around, just know I love you. Yeah. I appreciate the long days in the trap. Appreciate the road every time I made it back. You gon' respect me. I'm not stressing what you're talking about. Even if my haters come through to make you walk it out. Yeah. You keep on wearing the people. Come back and tell me what you be saying. You got me gifted from the Grammy. And I appreciate my real niggas. My family and friends. The struggle only made me just be greater within. I know the people that surround me keep it real. Cause half the ones I keep around, I'm
in the gym. I appreciate the money cause I grew up in the struggle. Appreciate the hood.
Shit, I definitely appreciate you for being on the couch. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Y'all know I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. Make sure you follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook, TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits right here on Instagram. Follow my main YouTube and Instagram, and my .com, which is THA Real J-A-N-E-L-L. Y'all see the shirt I got on? Highway Lines. They got some fire ass weed. I just gotta had to represent today. Okay. Yes, let's get to it, Voss Money. What up, though?
No, I'm doing good. How you doing?
I'm good. Can you tell everybody where you're located right now?
Right now I'm in VA. Okay. I'm from Petersburg, VA, but I'm located in Hampton right now.
Okay. So now, what is it like where you're from?
I would say it's kind of like any hood for real, you know. Everybody's trying to get some money, trying to make it out for real.
Right.
But like, ain't nothing wrong with it. I would say it ain't for the weak though. It ain't for no soft people.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you feel like it's real rough out there?
It's just like, if you're not from there, you're not used to it, it can be kind of rough.
Okay.
But I mean, if you're from there and you kind of know how stuff goes, then it ain't too bad.
So what's some pointers for somebody that's never been there before?
I would say stay out the way. Okay. It ain't yeah, just stay out the way.
Right. Okay. That respect, you know. Y'all, if you ever go to VA, make sure that y'all stay out the way. Y'all don't want them problems.
Yeah, but it's fun stuff to get. It's stuff to get into. I mean, if you like in Virginia Beach area, it's stuff to do. You know what I'm saying? Or Richmond, stuff in the city too.
Okay, I used to live in Richmond.
Oh, all right. Oh, so you know?
Yeah. I just want my viewers don't know. So. Now, I noticed with your music that you're not afraid to talk about like real stuff. As far as anxiety, depression, and stuff like that. What do you do for your anxiety and depression?
Shoot, I make music. Mm-hmm. I make music. I like to work out. That's really what I be doing. I just working out, making music. Sometimes I'll sit here, you know, watch some Netflix, Hulu, YouTube, or something like that. Mm-hmm. But mainly to help battle my emotions, really just the gym. And music kind of like my therapy to let everything out that be on my head at the time.
Mm-hmm. So is that your only two forms of therapy?
Right now, yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay. So are you against, like, counseling?
Oh, I'm definitely not against it. Okay. I used to go to counseling when I was little. A few years ago, I used to go mm-hmm. faithfully, at least, like, once a month.
Right.
I definitely encourage you to do help to talk to somebody.
Right. Now, what was some of the things that you maybe was going through that you would like to share that kind of made you rap about it in your music?
A few things I went through, so man, I ain't trying to get too personal on this show.
That's why it's called the Couch Chronicles. It ain't no limits. We do this.
Well, I had one friend. I had one friend. He got shot in the 7-Eleven. Mm. I mean, that kind of. I was pretty close with him. He was a real cool dude. I mean, that kind of messed me up a little bit because it was like, dang, like somebody like. At the time, I only knew him for like a year or two, but me and him, we were still cool. We were still rocking. It was kind of somebody I talked to on the regular.
Right.
So it was like, dang, like, he gone. Like, he cool with all my friends, too, and everything. So it was kind of weird.
Mm.
Then, like, I got a brother with a disability. So, you know, I'm always, you know, praying, and, like, he be trying to live his life through me and stuff like that. So that really be kind of getting in my head a lot too. But it's kind of like, damn, like, that's my big brother. You know what I'm saying? I'm used to him, you know, beating me up and getting mad about me eating the last ice cream and shit, you know?
Right.
But now it's like, you know, he's legally blind. You know, he needs a walker to help walk him and stuff like that. So it's hard to kind of look at him, somebody you love like that, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then I was in love at one point. Well, I thought I was anyway. Mm-hmm. But I mean, her true colors ended up showing, so. I guess it was just kind of a little puppy love or something.
Mm. Why? Because it was easy to give it up or you didn't want to work through your problems?
I tried working through the problems, but, you know, I feel like, you know, everybody got their non-negotiables. Like, it's some stuff you're just not going to tolerate. You know,
and
you're
what's not
gonna
that?
You're not going to tolerate a liar. Ain't going to tolerate a cheater. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, people are different, though. People come with their different personalities and different things like that, and that's okay.
Right.
And that's something... And everything, we can talk about anything, though. Anything can be talked about.
Right.
I definitely firmly believe that. But you got to be willing to have conversations, though.
That's true. That's so true.
Yeah, so a lot of people don't have that maturity to have those kind of conversations.
Mm-hmm. That's definitely true. Now, how long have you been doing music?
Shoot. I've been doing music since about 2017, 2018. I really started, like, locking in, taking it serious around 2020.
Mm-hmm. Now, what made you start taking it serious?
When I was younger, I was just all about sports. Like, all I want to do is play football. Like, I'm going to the league. Like, that's really all I cared about. But then, you know, like, I ended up going to college for football, things like that. It was cool, but it kind of started feeling like a job. I started not liking it no more. So then, next thing you know, COVID hit, and my homeboys had, like, a little home studio up in one of their attics. Right. And they was like, hey, bro, let's go to the studio. Like, let's see how this shit go. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, man, I can't rap. Like, you know, we always sit around and freestyle, you know, have fun and joke and stuff like that. But I ain't never done, like, for real, for real. Mm-hmm. So, having to do it for real on the mic and then, like, playing it for other people. And it was like, no, they was fucking with it. It was like, oh, this kind of hard, bro. Like, you might want to start taking this kind of serious. So that really kind of motivated me, you know, hearing other people start actually liking it and want me to send them a song and stuff like that. I was like, all right, yeah, I need to go ahead and lock in.
That's what's up. I'm glad you're still doing music because I was listening to your shit. It's fire.
For sure, yeah. You remember the show in Oklahoma?
Yeah,
that was good. Honestly, y'all had a great vibe. Like, that was one of the best, like, the vibe was there. One of the best shows I thought, like, I had, honestly.
Really?
Because, like, you know what I'm saying? Y'all was real supportive. And then, like, you know, hearing y'all sing my song back to me, I'm just kind of like, oh, damn. Like, you know what I'm saying?
One thing about us, like, when we listen to music, especially me and my wife and my cousin, like, because my cousin usually always go out with us, too. When we hear music, good music, like, it just speaks out of you. Like, it just comes right out of you. Like, you've been knowing it forever. Like, that's good music. Good music gives you chills. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, like, I was at this show the other day, and this dude was just going crazy. And I just was like, oh, shit. I got the chills. Like, I love that shit. For real. Now, how important is it to get your music mixed and mastered?
Well, I think it's super important because when you get it mixed and mastered, it kind of sometimes it can clean your voice up a little bit, make it sound more loud and clear. And then a lot of times, you know, people listen to music for different things. Some people listen to music on a radio. Some people might have a speaker. Some people might be in the headphones, and you want your stuff to sound the same, like, no matter where it's played. So that's why I feel like getting it mixed and mastered is, like, super important, because one person might hear stuff in the car, like, oh, this sounds kind of weird. Like, but then another person might hear it in the headphones, like, oh, it sounds tough in the headphones, though. Like, but you want it to be the same everywhere.
Right. Exactly. Now, whose fault is it whenever your vocals auto-tune is off?
It could be either one. It could be you or it could be the engineer. Okay. If it's the person, because, I mean, sometimes people do put bad vocals on the beat. Like, if you put bad vocals, it's not going to sound better. It's because you put some auto-tune on it.
Okay, so let me ask you this again. Whose fault is it if the song is out, if the vocals auto-tune is off?
Oh, yeah, that's on the artist.
Really?
For sure. Because, I mean, well, it depends, though. If you sign to a label and they put it out, I mean, sometimes you can't control that. But if it's you, like, you putting your music out and stuff like that, it's on the artist. Like, if you listen to it and you, like, because, you mean, you know what, people know what sound good, what don't sound good. So if you listen to it and you know, like, oh, the vocals kind of off, all right, work with the engineer, get it right before you just put it out, because you want yourself to be perfect when you put it out.
I'm going to tell you this, though. A real engineer, and you too, listen to me, a real engineer will never, ever, ever, ever let your track out without the mixing being, because part of the mixing is making sure that the auto tune is correct.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
So that's the job of the engineer, the producer and engineer. That's his job, to make sure that your vocals is at A1. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. If you paid him to mix your song, those vocals better be on point. Because guess what? They can actually, and I've seen it done. They can actually change your tune to the right key.
They
can. Just that one note.
They can. They can change to the right key.
Yeah. So if it was really off and it was really wrong and they couldn't get you back into the studio, they can. A real engineer could really do it themselves. They don't even need you. You've done all you need to do. For real. I'm telling y'all, I've seen it plenty of times. It's amazing to see, and I'm just like, yeah, I know it can be done. So, you know, you gotta, if you're an engineer and you listening, you gotta push yourself, you know. I'm a producing engineer myself, and I push myself every day to learn more and more and more. So, who's your musical inspiration?
Inspiration. We talk like new school, old school.
We talk about your school, whatever you want.
So when I was younger, like I listened to whatever like my dad listened to. So he was always blasting Tupac in the house all the time.
Aww.
But then as I got, then my mom was always listening to like Charlie Wilson.
Okay.
Yeah, like, you know, it's like the soul music.
Yeah, but Charlie Wilson is from here.
You said what?
I said Charlie Wilson is from here.
Oh, Oklahoma for real?
Yep.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
Mm-hmm. But like, how ironic school, is that?
Yeah, a lot of people probably don't know that.
Wow. That's dope, though, that was what you was listening to growing up. And yeah, who knew that you was going to end up doing a whole show in Oklahoma?
Yeah.
Ain't that dope? Do you believe in signs?
Like Zodiac?
I mean, just like things happen for a reason. And.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I love it. He said, like, Zodiac, what is your Zodiac sign?
I'm a Pisces.
Okay, we fucks with those. Y'all, if you're just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. It's my first, they said the Oklahoma Gap Band, Charlie Wilson, of course. Yes, he was with the Gap Band. But, you know, he was doing his own thing. Hey, girl. Oh, wait, that ain't his name. Oh, yes, it is.
Yeah, that is
it. I was like, wait a minute. Yeah, it is. Y'all follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook, TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram, and my main YouTube, Instagram.com. T-H-A, real J-A-N-E-L-L. I got Voss Money on the motherfucking couch. All the way in V-A, okay? And like he said, if you ain't from V-A, you better make sure that you stay out the way, okay? And you heard it right here on the couch. Now, how old are you, like 22?
I'm 24.
Okay, I was close. Wasn't I, y'all?
Yeah. Real close.
Yeah, real close. Now, what has been your best moment musically?
Best moment musically? Mm-hmm. I would have to say, all right, so best moments had to either be performing in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. My very first time ever performing in Atlanta, like, that was lit. Like, the crowd was really into it.
Yeah.
When I did the feature with Lil Papa, that was a good moment. Cause mm-hmm. it was like, I was in the studio with him, you know, we was wrapping it up and stuff. Like, it was good to get some advice from somebody like in the game like that.
Right.
And then, when I made my song Rain, like, I don't know, after I made that song,
S-E-R.
Like, I
just stuff to,
yeah, like, yeah. It was kind of, that was really a low point in my life when I made that song. I mean, I really just put it all out there. Like, I don't think I even wrote
that. That's the one, the main song that I really was just like, damn, what was you going through? Like, I want to know it. Like, is that too much? I don't care. It's the Couch Chronicles. Listen, I need to know, like, what? That song was just like, yo, you was talking that shit. It was like, you was just putting all of your feelings just on the track, like.
I told you, I thought I was in love type stuff. And then it's crazy because Shawty ended up like messing.
Allegedly.
I'm about 90% sure because a lot of stuff happened. A lot of evidence came out. So I'm about 90% sure she was fucking with a nigga I knew.
Oh.
Yeah. So I was like, damn. And it's crazy because it was a nigga she tried to warn me about months before. The next thing you know,
What you mean warn you? Like, what type of warn? Like, oh, he gonna beat your ass.
Saying that he was trying to get at her and shit like that. And I was like, all right, like, I told her I was gonna handle this shit. She's like, no, I got it. Oh, yeah, I bet you do got it. Like,
I'm afraid to ask what her zodiac sign was.
She was Scorpio.
Oh, okay. That sounds normal for them. What y'all gotta say? Scorpios, what y'all gotta say? No. Can you tell us a little bit about your heritage?
My heritage? Well, I'm Black, Native American. My parents like grew up Christian type stuff. Like, I mean, I don't know too much. I know my grandma was like really Native American.
See, I figured you was being facetious on your page when you said you was an island boy.
That was because I was in Jamaica.
Okay, I was like, he just in Jamaica talking about island boy. They gonna be like, I said, let me just ask him just in case. He'd be like, well, I am part Jamaican, Haitian. I have to just make sure.
Nah. If I am, I don't know about it.
How was your experience there?
Oh, it was great. I had a real good time in Jamaica. I think, man, I was killing them beef patties out there.
Oh, yeah. What did you eat it with cocoa bread?
Nah, I ain't had a cocoa bread one.
No, you got to eat it with the cocoa bread. The beef patty, the cocoa bread, and you just... Okay, before I went vegan, I'm telling you. Yeah. Now, in Atlanta, they got some the vegan version. So...
I was there for a week. I had a beef patty every day, sometimes two times a day.
Oh, yeah. Sometimes that's all I used to eat. Don't even need to eat nothing during the day because that is so fulfilling. I get it.
Yes.
I get it.
I was crushing them.
What did you drink?
You know, they love that rum out there. So, like, I just had a whole bunch of rum punch. I was having, like, rum punch over and over and over again. No pina coladas here and there. We was on a resort, so you know it was just like nonstop drinks.
You went with your girlfriend that was the one you was with at the time?
Yeah, at the time.
Okay,
yeah.
Spoiled her before she let you go, or you let her go?
Hey, I ain't even gonna lie, she kind of spoiled me though, because she paid for most of that trip. I ain't even gonna cap on her like that.
It says, I want to visit Jamaica in the future. Yes, okay, Nicole, I see you on YouTube. You said she was your puma. Oh no, she was like a cougar. Pumas is the ones that cook.
She went with a cougar. I mean, she was younger than me, but
okay.
She, yeah.
Oh, she loved you too.
Maybe at the time.
Okay. Now, what's your strongest point? Performances or recording?
My strongest point. You said recording, right?
Mm-hmm. Performances or recording?
I would say recording.
Why would you say that?
I don't know. Like, it's just... Well, I mean, I feel like I'm pretty decent at performing, you know what I'm saying? If it's a hype song, I mean, if it's a turn song, that's too easy. But, I mean, sometimes it'd be a little harder for me when I'd be on the stage to, like, really kind of, like... So, say I'm performing Rain.
Right, I was going to ask that.
It's hard to kind of really get in that mode, you know, like, all right, now I got to kind of reminisce on these thoughts that I kind of been trying to bury and kind of sing this song to the people. I got to, you know, put some passion behind it. Like, so that'd be a little tougher to do, like, on the spot like that in public.
Does that make you scared or does it make you nervous?
It's different for me because I don't want to say I'm a real nonchalant person, but if I'm going through something, I don't really be showing that I'm going through something, you know? So, like, for me to sit there and be having to kind of give that expression, give that emotion while I'm performing that, like, a strong song like that, like, an emotional song like that, it can be a little difficult. I've been getting better at it, you know, just showing people my sensitive side, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But now, let me ask you this. You did a video for it, right?
Yeah, I did a video for it.
So, was you being fake in the video with your facial expressions?
Nah, that was real. I was feeling it that day. Yeah, okay. I shot the video recently after the song. It's probably like a couple weeks after the song.
Okay. So that's what we want to see on stage.
Yeah. I know. I gotta let it come out. I gotta just let it come out and just flow with it.
How was you? Okay, so what makes... Okay, so let's change that. Are you more comfortable in front of the camera or in front of the mic?
Like, in the booth front of the mic or, like, on the stage in front of the mic?
On the stage.
I'd probably say in front of the... I'd probably say in front of the camera. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've gotten used to performing. Like, I've done it so many times now, kind of just, like, second nature now. But before, like, making music videos, that kind of came pretty naturally. Like, I was just right with it. Right. But performing after a few times... well, actually, my first performance was real good. That's actually how I ended up kind of meeting the dude I came with to the OKC show, Two Official. That's kind of how I met him. My first show, he saw it, and he thought I rocked out.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'd probably stay behind the camera.
Okay. Okay. So would you
want to
do some acting, too?
I really wouldn't mind it. You know, when I was younger, I used to be, like, in the plays and stuff.
Oh, really?
And I always wanted to kind of get back into it. My homeboy I told you about got shot at 7-Eleven. He was doing, like, theater and stuff like that. He was kind of going to help me get into it.
So what's up? You what's up? That shit would be dope.
That's what I'm saying.
What type of plays was you doing when you was young?
Say it one time.
What type of plays was you doing?
Oh, I was doing like little kid plays. Like, I can't even remember. It was so long ago. It was like elementary, middle school. Because in high school, I was just focused on straight sports.
We did the Miracle Worker. That was one of my favorite ones.
Okay.
I love plays. Like, I mean, I would go to a play right now. Like, I love shit like that. I'm a cornball, and of course, I'm old, so, you know.
I love plays, too. When I was in college, I was going to all the plays they had.
See? Oh, yeah, because they be lit. They do the dancing and shit. Yeah, I know. they was lit. Are you signed by anyone?
Currently, no.
Okay, so I looked it up on Google, and it says you have a record label. Is that yours?
Nah, the distribution, because I use DistroKid for my distribution, and you can put whatever you want on there, like for your for like the label. So like when me and my homeboys was up in the attic, I had there's another artist up in there. He was named Floyd. We was like, oh, Floyd Records. You know, we were just flowing with it.
I was like, who is this company? I got to do my research. Like, hold on. So I had to ask. That is hilarious. Wow.
Yeah.
I never expected you to say any of that.
Yeah, it was our little funny thing.
It is funny. Because it got brought back up.
Yep. You ain't the first person to bring it back up either.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, what are you doing music for? What's your purpose?
Like I said, it's kind of like that avenue to express myself. Mm-hmm. That was really the purpose. But I mean, honestly though, I love it though. I honestly love everything about it. Mm-hmm. Like I love going to the shows. I love shooting music videos. I really love being in the studio. Like I can sit in the studio all day long, 8-9 hours. And it ain't even like time go by so fast because I be enjoying myself.
Facts. I'm so thankful I have my own studio because I will be running up a bill.
Yeah, I'm in the process of building mine.
Oh yeah. If you ever need some pointers, some tips, or anything to buy or just let me know.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to get with you for sure.
Now, have you ever been compared to a mainstream artist?
A couple of times. One person, I've been compared to Youngboy. I've been compared to Rod Wave. And I'd have been compared to Dirk at one time, too.
Wow.
This is just people being like, you kind of sound like, you know, people stay saying stuff like that, so.
Okay, I'm going to have to go re-listen, because I was listening to your last album you just dropped.
Yeah, Cold Money.
And I don't know if I got any of those.
Yeah, I mean, I sound like me. I don't think I sound like nobody. But right.
But I got to re-listen. If I'm wrong, I will let you know. I'm going to be like, I'm going to really pay attention on now. That's crazy. I didn't think you would say that. Now, what opportunities do they have for artists where you're located right now?
They got like a few like local labels out here. Mm-hmm. They got some, they always have a bunch of open mics going on. Mm-hmm. It'd be a bunch of networking events, things like that. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, we're real close to North Carolina. North Carolina always got something going on for music. Mm-hmm. Like, Charlotte's really starting to come up in the music scene, so it's, like, always something to do. And it's only, like, a good, like, 3-4-hour drive.
Okay, that ain't nothing.
Yeah. Mm-mm.
So, y'all do, you said, open mics and stuff like that?
Yeah, they there's a few people, especially in Richmond, that be doing like open mics every week.
Mm-hmm. So every what are y'all showcases like? Do they charge artists to get on stage to perform, or what's that like?
A lot of times it'll just be like, if you come before a certain time, you perform for free. Mm-hmm. Or if you come after that certain time, you pay like $10. You want to do two songs, maybe pay like $20, $30.
Okay.
Yeah, it don't be that bad for real. You can buy a section in there for like $40. It ain't nothing.
Oh, yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad. Especially whenever you go into new states. Sometimes, I don't know about y'all, but as an artist, and as a podcaster, I look for certain things to do musically when I go to different states. I don't just go to a different state just to go see, like, sightseeing. No, I want to sightsee and I want to see some music, okay, in different states. I love to see music in different states. When I went to Salt Lake City, Utah, they was on the side of the club just in the cut, just it just rapping. I didn't even make it into the club.
Oh, wow.
They couldn't rap, but they was just so into it that I was mesmerized.
Yeah. Oklahoma surprised me. Like, out of all the cities we went to, like, y'all had some talent out there. Like, I was surprised. Like, honestly surprised. Like, wow. Really? Like, because, like, all the places I've been, you know, it's been like, all right, some people be all right, some people be pretty good, mm-hmm. some people, you know, they be trash, I ain't gonna lie. Right. But then, like, when I went to Oklahoma, though, I was like, man, like, it was just, you know, banger after banger. Like, everybody come up there was really doing their thing. Mm-hmm. Like, I was into it. I'm watching everybody that came up.
Facts. Shout out to all the artists in Oklahoma City that's watching. Y'all already know that y'all fire. Keep going. Don't stop. Any other artists that's watching, you keep going as well. Don't stop. I don't give a fuck how hard it get. I don't give a fuck if you can't pay for your music video. I don't care if you can't pay to put whatever. Keep going. Don't stop. Eventually, you gonna get some videos. If y'all just now tuning in, it is the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. If you're watching on Instagram, make sure that you share it live. I usually stream on Facebook, so if you're watching on Instagram and you're watching on YouTube and you're used to it, listen, I know. I'll make sure I put a good clip on YouTube and Instagram and Facebook. So follow the pages. Follow my guest, Voss Money, on all social media. His information is in the description. It's all about love, support, good vibes, and positive energy. And that's all we're trying to spread, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what's your struggle like for as an artist? Like, is there anything that you're struggling with the most? Like I just mentioned a second ago, sometimes it's hard for people to get music videos. What has been your biggest struggle as an artist?
Biggest struggle? Honestly, I would say finding, like, reliable people. Like, you know, you need a reliable cameraman, you need a reliable studio. Right. Like, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people be doing bad business, like real bad business. So especially out here in VA, like it's hard. Like it's hard to find quality. Like honestly, if you ask me, it's hard to find quality anything out here. Mm-hmm. But I done built a couple good relationships with a couple, you know, good, decent cameraman. I find a decent studio, you know what I'm saying? Because me, I'm a loyal person. Like, once I go somewhere and it's good, I'm going to just keep rocking with you. Like,
right.
I'm not the type of person to keep shopping around and, like, you already show me good quality work, you know what I'm saying? But it just be a little tough.
Right. Now, do y'all have a problem with people, like, trying to scam you, like, as far as, like, getting on shows or anything like that?
Shows, not really, but if you're trying to get a music video shot or some kind of promotion stuff, sometimes they do be trying to scam. I done took some losses before with that type of stuff. People like, and it's crazy though, because it'll be people that actually, like, they'll do most of the people that hit them up, and then some people they gonna scam. Like, they don't always be scamming. Mm-hmm. So yeah, you just gotta, you know, but especially like they know who to scam and who not to scam.
Right. Now, who or what has helped you get to where you are now?
Where I am now? Really, like, the support from my friends, mm-hmm. support from family, been real, real good. Two official, QC, like, he really was cool, you know, like, mm-hmm. taking me on a road with him and things like that, that really helped, you know, get me seen to other states. That really helped further my career too. But yeah, the support from friends is definitely huge, because I mean, sometimes you're gonna have down moments. You need people that's gonna, you know, want you to keep on pushing, keep pushing you forward, motivating you.
Mm-hmm. Right. Now, when it comes to the business side of your music, do you handle it, or is there someone else that handles that?
I handle it. I handle majority of it. I don't handle all of it, but majority of it I do.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Who handles your other side? You got a manager for that?
No, I mean, well, when I was on the road with Two Official, he handled some of the business side. Mm-hmm. But like, that was kind of while we was on the road, stuff like that. But I mean, now I'm back home doing a lot of local stuff, so I've been handling all of it.
Okay. Was it hard to learn, or?
Not really. Mm-hmm. I mean, if it's something you passionate about, something you love, you're going to take the time to learn it. Like, exactly. I used to be at my job just watching YouTube videos about the business side and watching, like, listening to stories about how they was coming up and things like that. You listen to ones that already made it. They know a little something.
Right. That's so true. Now, who do you register your music through?
BMI.
Okay. Now, where do you do your music platform through?
I do all the distribution and all that stuff through DistroKid.
Okay, and why?
Because it was just the first thing. When I first started, we was making music in the attic. My homeboy was like, "Oh, I've been using DistroKid, yada yada yada." So that's just what I started using. Okay. But if it's something better, you know, let me know.
What benefits have you gotten from DistroKid?
I mean, I like how you just kind of put it up there, and they just gonna send it out to everybody, like. You know, you, like I said, like how I was able to put whatever I wanted to for the little label.
Okay, so and are then, you able to send it to the NBA?
To the NBA? I honestly don't know.
Okay.
Honestly don't know.
Maybe you should look into some other platforms.
No, I definitely am. I've been looking into other platforms, you know. That's one thing I kind of, that was another trouble I was having, like finding the right distribution company to use.
Right.
I mean, there's so many out there, but you really don't know who the best one to use is, because everybody be having good times and bad times with all of them.
Facts. So I used to use DistroKid. I also used to use CD Baby. I started with CD Baby, then I went to DistroKid, and then I went to United Masters. I'm with United Masters now. For those that don't know, they offer, what up though, Bishop? Y'all, if you're looking for any dogs, I'm telling you, he got the best. He's a good doodle dad. And I'm a doodle stepmom, right? Yeah. But United Masters offers different platforms as far as being able to get into your music into the NBA, being able to be considered onto TV shows, Snapchat, different platforms. It's really, really dope. I say if you haven't already checked it out, you can check it out. They also offer to mix and master your music. They also offer, if you can't get to your engineer, or they offer that as well. They also offer, you can get your music out within a week. I think they even have a 7-day turnaround. I mean, a 3-day turnaround. So, you just got to look into it. It's really a good one to look into. So, yes. Now, if y'all haven't already done so, make sure that you check out and follow Voss Money on all social media. Follow the Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Spotify. TikTok and Facebook. CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram. And my main YouTube, Instagram, and .com. Which is THA Real JANELL. If you would like to support the couch, you can Cash App, PayPal, or Chime, THA Real JANELL. I still got a honeymoon jar, so if you want to support, y'all know we just got married. We still got a honeymoon jar. Shout out to Nicole and Crystal for getting the honeymoon jar put together. I had a lid, but my dog ate it.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, how do you promote your music?
Just Instagram, YouTube promotion. Sometimes you can use an outside party to, you know, promote your stuff, but you got to make sure they're reliable.
Mm-hmm. Do you pay for streams and do you pay for views?
just pay for the advertisement. And if I get streams and views from the advertisement, that's what it is.
Now, why do you think it's so hard for upcoming artists to come, like, just come out right now, like, and just without a huge backing?
Oh, because it costs some money. Like, if you ain't got no money, like, you're not going to make it in this game. I'm just being honest, because right. You can have all the talent in the world, but if you got the money to pay the blogs, pay the distribution company, pay the podcast, like podcast people, like if you ain't got the bread to like pay for the advertisement to get your name out there, it's not gonna happen. Right. People gotta see you. That's the biggest thing, is being seen. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's the biggest way to be seen, do you think, is right now?
I think, to me, you definitely want to travel. TikTok is real huge right now. Mm-hmm. If you know somebody that's kind of already made it, and you can kind of maybe hop in one of their videos or something like that, or get them to promote your stuff, shout you out, you know, I feel like that's big. I mean, having somebody vouch for you, people gonna listen to somebody. They listen, like, they like listen to that person. They be like, oh, he's talking about ER. Like, let me see what he talk about.
Right.
But yeah, like little things like that.
Mm-hmm. Is music all that you do?
Right now, yeah, I got a little part-time.
Okay.
I got a little part-time, but majority of the time just doing music and working out and stuff.
Okay. Now, what's been, this is probably going to get kind of deep, what's been on your mind and heart lately?
I got to get some money. I need to get some more money. Right. I'm doing all right, you know what I'm saying? Still kind of in my early 20s, about to be mid-20s, really. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I'm not doing bad. It's all right. But, you know, I'm trying to be where it's like, oh, I know, like, whatever come up, I'm good. No matter what come up, I'm good, you know?
Right. What do you think about adulthood?
It has its moments. You know, it has its moments where you be enjoying it. But, I mean, oh, my gosh. It's right. Like, so it just bills after bills. All this stress, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, I'm a young adult, so I'm already looked at as a certain way.
Right.
You know, so it'd be hard, like, dealing with the, like, some people be harassing you, belittling you, you know, just because you're younger, and it's like, mm-hmm. So I mean, but it's, like I said, it has its ups and downs, it has its moments.
Right. So, in your opinion, what did you have, a better childhood or adulthood? Hey, wifey, I love you.
As of right now, as of right now, I'm going to say childhood, but mm-hmm. still early in the adulting, so.
Okay. Now, how would you like people to experience you?
Shoot. Experience me? I mean, really, just come talk to me. Like, I'm a chill person. Mm-hmm. Okay. I feel like I'm real chill. I like the joke. You know what I'm saying? You can kind of get to know me a little bit through my music, but mm-hmm. really, you got to talk to me, like, to know me.
Right.
But, yeah, that's what I always say.
What's one thing that you would share today that you haven't shared with anyone about you?
About me? Mm-hmm. That's a real good question. That's a real good question. I don't know. Shoot, I'll just say I got some big stuff coming up. That's all I'm gonna say. I got some big stuff coming up. Watch out for it. You know what I'm saying? New music, new videos, all that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, what's one thing that you've done in your life, whether it's been musically or just anything, that you're most proud of?
Most proud of. When I was younger, I always said I'm gonna play Division I football. Like, I'm gonna do it. Right. I mean, put the time in, worked hard, and I made it. So that was real big for me. It's like, dang, like, you know, and it really showed, like, when you work hard at something, you can do whatever you want to do. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what's up, for real. Now, looking back on your life and your past experience, who or what makes you light up instantly?
Who or what?
Yeah.
Well, shoot. anytime I could go, anytime I could go, like, say if it's a homeboy or somebody I haven't seen in a while, mm-hmm. and we could still just sit and talk and rap, like if we just left each other yesterday type stuff, that'd be lighting me up. Like, always seeing my friends and my family, that always lights me up every time. That's really the most important thing.
That's what's up. Who do you hang around the most, your family or friends? You got a lot of friends?
Yeah, I got a few friends. I got one out here with me right now.
Okay, yo. What up, though?
Yeah, I be with my homeboys all the time.
Okay. Is he doing his schoolwork?
I got about two.
I said he doing his schoolwork?
Nah, he was. He chilling now, though.
Okay. Into the schoolwork. That's what's up. What does he do? He's an artist as well?
No, I'm a counselor.
Yeah, counselor.
Okay. Can we say hello to the camera?
Yeah. What's going on?
Hi, what's your name? Can you tell everybody your name?
My name is Jamie. What's going on? What's your name?
My name is Janelle. I'm with the Couch Chronicles No Limits podcast.
Janelle, nice to meet you.
How long have you been a counselor?
Really? I've been a counselor for like a year.
Mm-hmm.
I work with young men.
Okay.
So.
What made you want to be a counselor?
What initially made me want to be a counselor is I took a psychology class, 6-7 years ago, the last year in high school,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, I was feeling it. And then, like, my mom had passed my freshman year in college, and that kind of drove me, like, mental health for men is, like, it's not, like, it's, like, a whole different space. It's, like, a whole, especially black men, it's, like, a whole different route that we got to get underneath, and I'm trying to find my way through it. Like, I want to, like, blend fitness and counseling. I don't know exactly how I want to do it, but it's something I got my heart on. So.
Yeah. That's dope. Yeah. That's dope. I hope we can get you on the couch, and I could ask you a bunch more questions. Thank you so much for answering my questions.
That's nothing.
Yes. Please send me your information. We definitely got to get you on the couch. I've been looking to have a counselor on the couch. For real. Yes. I had a couple counselors that said they want to be on, but they got so busy. So hopefully you get some time and you come back to the couch. Thank you so much for sharing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Let me get my interview back, man.
Y'all, we got Voss Money on the motherfucking couch. He had to snatch the phone back. But y'all, listen, wasn't that dope? See, this is what I love about the couch, because I get to meet people, ask different questions, get to learn people. Like, that's dope. How ironic. Yo, that's fire. That's fire. We got to get him back on the couch. Y'all, if you just now tuning in, like I said, it is the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Today is Taco Tuesday. Did y'all eat some tacos today?
Sure, I had some nachos.
Okay. That's kind of not the same, but you could have got it from Taco Bell if you would have went there.
Yeah.
Taco Tuesday, y'all. Make sure you follow Voss Money on all social media. It's all about love, support, good vibes, and positive energy, and that's all we trying to spread. Make sure that you follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok, CouchChronicles.NoLimits on Instagram, my main YouTube, Instagram, and .com, which is THA Real JANELL. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the like button. If you're watching on Instagram, you can still share it live. I got a few more questions, and then we're going to wrap it up.
All right.
So do you have kids?
No, I don't.
Okay. What about fur babies?
Fur babies?
Yes.
Like, what you mean?
Like a little pupper or a bird?
Oh, yeah. I got my little doll right up.
Oh. What's his name?
His name, Cairo.
Cairo. It's Janelle from the couch. Hey. He's so cute. Now, what's the best piece of advice that you've ever gotten?
Best piece of advice? Mm-hmm. Best piece of advice was, honestly, is to... How do I say this? Mm-hmm.
I kind of took this and kind of used it in life. So as I was coming up in sports, you know, I was a wide receiver. So they kind of told me, they was like, all right, like, as you get up in these sports, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're younger right now, so the ball is just kind of coming to you. Mm. They was like, but as you get older, you know, everybody gonna be good. So it ain't gonna just come to you. You gotta go take it. Mm. So I was like, all right, so from now on, you know, as I get older, like, if I want something, I gotta go get it. Ain't nobody gonna just pass it to me, you feel me?
Right. Who said that to you?
I ain't gonna lie, I was watching that on TV.
what was you watching, All American?
Nah, it was on The Game.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, damn, like, that's facts, though. You gotta go take it, though.
Now, what you said, you have projects, and do you have any shows coming up?
Yeah, I got a show this weekend, the 24th in Greensboro.
Okay. And y'all make sure that y'all check out his page. If you're near the Greensboro area, make sure that you go out and support. Yes.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Now, how do you get booked on the shows? Like, how do you find shows in different states? Like, how you do that?
It started out just like people locally I would meet, like, some people would be music managers, some people would be promoters and stuff, and people I would meet would let me know about shows going on. But then now that I've been on that tour, right, I'd have met so many promoters, DJs, like, did so much networking that now other artists also, like, another artist told me about this show in Greensboro.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
And so that's how I got hooked up with that one.
Okay.
But really, it's all about the connections you make. Like,
right. All connections, networking, y'all. Network. Wherever you go, I don't give a fuck. Like, do you consider yourself shy?
I wouldn't say so.
Okay, so are you a people's person?
I ain't no people person. I definitely ain't no people's person. But I wouldn't say I'm shy, you know what I'm saying? If I go somewhere and the vibe good, I'm going to talk to everybody. But right. If I go somewhere and somebody's kind of like, their vibe seem a little off, because I like to look at people and kind of, I don't want to say read them, but I look at how their emotion is at the time, and I'll be like, oh, nah, they ain't trying to be fucked with.
Right. See, even the ones that look like they not trying to be fucked with, I'd be like, hey, my name is Janelle. I'm about to get on the stage. Da-da-da-da. I give them my little spiel. I'd be like, I also got a podcast. Yada, 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 yada. Let me get your Instagram. I exchange Instagram. We do all of that. And I'll be like, I'm looking forward to seeing you on stage. And that's that. So by the time I get on stage, they'll be like, oh, shit, that's that one girl that came up to me when I didn't want to be talked to. Fuck yeah, that's me. Yo, my last question that I do have is, if you could change one thing about the music industry, what would it be?
One thing about music industry I would change. Mm-hmm. I'd probably change the interactions. Mm-hmm. Like, everything is just so straight business. You know what I'm saying? Like, all the time. Like, everybody's like, all right, I'm here. I'm doing what I gotta do with my money at. You know what I'm saying? Yes. It ain't like, oh, how you doing, bro? Oh, I like your music. Oh, like, you so, like, oh, you trying to get in the studio? You cool? Like, what? It don't really be a whole lot of that. It'd be like, all right, I'm here for this. I'm going to do this, and I'm gone. I'm here for the money, I'm gone. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that's probably one thing I would change. Like, it is a lot of fake people in the industry. I only got, like, a foot in the industry, and I'm already seeing how crazy it is.
Right.
Like, all the fakeness, all the bad business, like, I'm seeing all of it already. So, like, imagine, like, as I keep going up, like, I'm really going to get worse and worse. That's right. Probably one thing I would change. Like, mm-hmm. I know it's a business, and you got to make sure you handle it. You got to always stand on it, you know, handle your business. But it still could be a little more enjoyable. People seem like it's so hard. Like, they be like, oh, I got to do this. Let me get high real quick. Like, mm-hmm. You know.
Right. Does it discourage you a little bit, though? You know, knowing that the higher you go, the worse it's going to get.
I mean, it used to discourage me, you know what I'm saying? But it's just like, I know I'm gonna be good regardless. Like, I already have a good support system. Like, my friends and family support me so much that it's like, all right, I don't, like, I'm gonna go somewhere, and if they fucking with me too, all right, cool. You support me, I'm gonna support you. Right. But if it's somebody that's just on straight business, all right, we just be on straight business, and I'm gonna go about mine. Because mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I already got support. I got friends and family. I really don't. I, at this point, like, I don't really need nobody else. You know.
Right. Now, I do want to ask this because, you know, a lot of times when we see artists, male artists, black male artists in particular, you know, on these labels, passing away, or do you have fear, you know, maybe coming up in the game and possibly getting knocked off just by something, just a hater or?
Nah, not really. Cause I mean that comes with the game, but really that comes with anything. You know, I could walk out the door and get knocked off today.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It could really happen at any time. Yeah, you got a little more status, so you got to move a little differently. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't be hanging out in one spot too long. Make sure you got some kind of security.
Right.
Cause I mean, it is a lot of jealousy out there, a lot of envy. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times, you know, people want to take what you got just cause you got more than them. You might even know the person. You might even know the person. And they just see, oh, he winning. I'm trying to win. I'm gonna just go take what he got. Mm. You know, don't nobody want to work for nothing no more. Right. But still, like, I feel like, you know, it's a risk, but a risk comes with anything you do.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Have you lost friends along the way?
I have. I wouldn't say it was because of me though.
Okay.
Cause you know, it's like, but I don't lost friends over stupid shit though. Like I'm talking about like over, like say I do you a solid, right? Mm-hmm. I let somebody like stay in my apartment for like some or something like that.
Okay.
And they'd be like, oh yeah, I'm gonna help out with the rent. Woo doo woo doo woo. All right. So when it's time to come with the rent, all of a sudden you ain't got it and
right.
You just gonna dip out and you just gonna try to dip out. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, all right, I don't boss people over little shit like money.
Facts,
like that.
They do shit like that.
I done lost friends over women, and I be sitting here like, bro, like, what, like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, bro, we've been rocking for all this time,
right.
And you gonna sit here and just believe whatever she's saying, even though you just met this joint.
Right.
And I'm telling you what's going on, and you're not listening to me. It's like, is it that good? Like,
dog. Damn. Well, at least you got the solid ones that's with you right now, rocking with you, supporting your music, and keeping you motivated. For real.
Sure.
Y'all, make sure that you follow Voss Money on all social media. His information will be in the description. I will make sure that I put it there. Y'all, do you have anything, anybody that you want to shout out or anything?
Oh, yeah. Shoot, I want to shout out, my boy, I think my boy Tavari in the comments right now.
Hey.
Gotta shout out Tavari. Gotta shout out my engineer in the comments, that boy Max. Shoot, shout out Nina. Oh, shout out G Cool. Shout out Killian. Shout out Jada. Shout out Linwood. Shout out Ro.
Hey.
Goddamn. Ashlyn. Oh, shoot. Can't forget my boy Jamie right here.
Hey.
Shout out Michaela. Shoot, shout out my sister, Naya, my cousin,
okay,
boy
sis.
Keith. Shout out Kobe in the comments. Shoot, everybody tapped in.
Yeah, that's
oh, Delijah in the comments, shout out.
That's what's up. Shout out to everybody that's tuned in. If you fucking with the Couch Chronicles, make sure that you drop them couches. Y'all, I definitely appreciate Voss Money for being on the couch. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles and ain't no fucking limits. I do got a few more announcements before I wrap it up. So, y'all, I don't know if you tuned in yesterday, but you know we started discussion of the streets right here on the couch. So if you have an issue with somebody, you want to discuss it in an adult way, we can do that. That's what we're doing. So the first episode started yesterday, and we got another episode that's taking place this Friday. So it's actually going to be round two because it goes into what happened yesterday. So if you didn't catch yesterday's episode, I will go back and rewatch it because it's really about to get deep Friday. Now, Friday, my guest said that he is bringing receipts, and I don't mean from Walmart. So make sure that y'all tune in this Friday as well. Tomorrow, we are supposed to have Miss Tristan with Divine Sweets. So make sure that y'all tap in tomorrow. I mean, not tomorrow, but Thursday with her. Also, if you haven't gotten a chance, make sure that you check on your strong people. Check on your people. Anybody that you fuck with, make sure that you check on them. Depression is real. Times is hard. Some people still ain't got their taxes yet. Okay? So, you know, money is funny and change is strange. I tell y'all that all the time. So, you know, reach out to your people. If you know anybody that's locked up, write them. If you know anybody that is in the hospital, do a wellness check. Y'all already know why. It's okay. I'm about to get off anyway. I definitely appreciate you for being on the couch, Voss. For real. Y'all make sure that y'all follow Voss Money. His information, again, like I said, will be in the description. And it will be up on Spotify and Pandora. So all you got to do is like, subscribe. If you haven't gotten your taxes back, I want to give you a little bit of information. All you have to do, no matter what state you're in, all you have to do is call. Actually, look it up online. I forgot to put the number down. I meant to put it down. But it's for a tax advocate. Get you a tax advocate, and they'll help you get your taxes a little bit quicker than just sitting there waiting. So make sure that you do that. If you haven't gotten your taxes back, because you never know, something might have got sent to the wrong address, and something might need to get fixed, especially if it's still pending right now, and especially if you still haven't gotten your taxes yet. So if you are one of the ones that haven't gotten your taxes, get you a tax advocate. It's absolutely free, okay? I love you guys so much. It's Taco Tuesday. We have Voss Money on the fucking couch. Y'all, we don't often do our lives on the Instagram. So if you are seeing this on Instagram, make sure that you also follow the Facebook page. It's THA Couch on Facebook. I love y'all. It's the Couch Chronicles. And it ain't no fucking limits. I will see y'all on Thursday. Hey, y'all.